कवि श्री चैतन्य मोरे करिबे न दया, कवे आनि पाइबो वैष्णव पद छाया। कवे आमे छाड़िबो केई विषया विमान, कवे विष्णु जाने आमी करिबो सम्मान। गलवस्त्र कृतांजलि वैष्णव निकटे, दंते तृण करी दड़ा जीवनेष्कपटे,
गीतांजलि वैष्णव निकटे, दंते तृण करी दद आईब निष्कपटे।
कंदिया कंदिया जाना इव दुख ग्राम, संसार अनालते मागिव विश्राम।
कांदिया कांदिया जना आइव दुख ग्राम, संसार अनालते मागिब विश्राम।
सुनिया मार दुख वैष्णव ठाकुर, अमलागी कृष्णे आवे निवेना प्रचुर।
सुनिया अमार दुख वैष्णव ठकुर, हमारा लगी कृष्णे आवे दिवे ना प्रचुर।
वैष्णवे रवे दने कृष्ण दया माया, यह ना पमार प्रति हवे ना सदाया।
वैष्णव रवे दने कृष्ण दया माया, यह ना परमापति हवे ना सदाया।
विनोदर वैष्णव चराणे, कृपा करी संगे लह जय अकिंचने।
निवेदना वैष्णव चराणे, कृपा करी संगे लह किया के जान।
आवे श्री चैतन्य मोरे करिवे दया भले आवे पाइबो वैष्णव पर हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद भगवान हरि नाम संकीर्तन की अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की श्रील प्रभुपाद श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत की।
ओम ज्ञानतिमिरंदस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं। वन्देहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। नमावों विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिन्निति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषाशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द 16th चैप्टर। I remember we were in the section of Raghunath Das meeting Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We were in 227 verses we have completed in this chapter. So in this section of Raghunath Das's eagerness and Lord Chaitanya's counsel, 216 to 244. This is the section of the 16th chapter of Madhya Lila. Till now what you have heard is Hiranya Majumdar, Govardhan Majumdar, how they were very aristocratic family, and they were earning 12 lakh rupees per year, which means 1 lakh per month. They're very, very rich people. At the same time, they're very charitable to the brahmanas. All brahmanas actually depended on these two for the charity. They were very fond of patronizing the brahminical activities. That is a very wonderful thing to be appreciated. And they considered Nilambar Chakravarti to be like their elder brother. I mean, they considered like worshipable, but Nilambar Chakravarti considered them like his younger brothers. And they were also close to Mishra Purandara, who is Jagannath Mishra, father of Nimaya Pandit. So in this way, they were close to the family of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knew them very well. And also, Hiranya Majumdar's son was Raghunath Das, and Hiranya Majumdar had a temple in his house premises. His house was a huge place in Saptagram, house as well as the farm, and there was a temple also worshipped. So there the guru was like a Kula Guru we have. And they had a guru, Yadunandana Acharya, and Balram Acharya was the Pujari there. Yadunandana Acharya actually was very favorite. He considered Vasudev Datta his favorite. Similarly, Balram Acharya considered Haridas Thakur his favorite. So in this way, in the Saptagram, this family was close to great Vaishnava personalities like Vasudev Datta and Haridas Thakur. So Raghunath Das as a small boy had seen Haridas Thakur and developed a very great fondness for his bhajan. So later as he grew up, Raghunath Das once went and met Lord Chaitanya in Shantipur. And when he bowed down to Lord Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya kept his lotus feet on his head. So he became completely blessed and he went spiritually mad. He wanted to dedicate his life. That's where we stopped. Now let's proceed further. Verse number 228.
बार बार पलायते हो नीलाद्रियाते बार बार पलायते हो नीलाद्रियाते पिता तारे बांधी रखे रखे आनी पथ हाइते पिता तारे बांधी रखे आनी पथ हाइते। रघुनाथ दास यूज्ड टू रन अवे फ्रॉम होम अगेन एंड अगेन टू गो टू जगन्नाथपुरी बट हिज फादर केप्ट बाइंडिंग हिम एंड ब्रिंगिंग हिम बैक।
So Raghunath Das wanted to dedicate his life, but his father was a millionaire and he thought, oh, he is my son, he should actually become my successor in taking care of the home and taking care of all the business affairs connected to him. That was his plan. Often, a typical family in India, they would think that if my daughter is grown up and she gets married and settled, and if my son is grown up and he's settled in a business, is making good money, profits, and he is married and settled, then they think my duty is over. In India, people think this is their duty. Actually, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, Guru na sasyat, Vajino na sasyat, Pita na sasyat, Janani na sasyat, Daivam na tatsyat, na patishta sasyat, na mochayet yat sampeta brityum. It says, one should not become a guru. One should not become a relative, one should not become a father or a mother or even demigod or a husband unless they can deliver their dependents from the clutches of birth and death and send them back to Godhead. So if they cannot do that, they should not take this responsibility. But often people don't know about this. People generally tend to think that you know, material duties are the only duty. They think like that. This is one typical thing in India we have seen. Another thing, people think this material life becomes all important. Because people see the material life is very glaringly visible for everybody to see. Oh, he has car, he has bungalow, he has so much money earning, and they are living life lavishly. So people look at each other and often develop greed for growing in material life. Material life is symptomized by big shopping malls, big flashy cars, you know, costly dresses, opulent foods, moving amongst aristocratic circles, making a big money, traveling all over the world nowadays, and then earning big degrees in premier institutes, and being very popular figure in society, and having big number of fans following, being a superstar or something. So these are things certainly very attractive for a conditioned soul, but none of these things last with us. You know, like a foaming bubbles in the ocean. The bubbles look very big and very beautiful, but they don't last forever. They just are broken in a few moments. So, like the children play this soap bubble. You blow the soap bubbles with a pipe. When the bubbles come out, they look very multicolored, like a rainbow color. And when they're moving, they look very glossy, very attractive. But how long do they last? Material life is compared to that. Kamala dala jala, jeevana talamala. But people unfortunately are blind to this reality. They can't see the material life to be temporary. So they consider material life to be all in all. Because of that, and another thing also, people will also consider that my vamsha is very important. My father, my grandfather, we have the surname. And we have this land, we have this house, we have this business, we are big people, and our vamsha should continue, you know, generation lineage. Our lineage should continue. Therefore, my son should not become a renunciate. He should continue the lineage and produce more and more children. So, Prabhupada says, you know, there are two types of expansions, Prabhupada says. One is material expansion and spiritual expansion. Material expansion means a father begets a dozen children. And then they all get married and they beget their dozen children. So they expand the material life. So the father accumulates a lot of money, the children take away the money from the father. They loot the money from the father and they spend, and their children take away their money also. So in this way, their money of the father, and father is very happily laughing, telling his friends, I collected so much money, my children are looted away everything. And why they laugh, they are not feeling very too much bad also, because ultimately some outside person didn't loot. You know, my children only looted. You know, they become bondi. This is material life. Make a lot of money, allow it to be looted by your children, and expand the material population of your family through sex life. And this is considered a very big success in the material world. Whereas, the spiritual expansion means, to cut off the tie of material attachment means to broaden the field of spiritual activities. So Prabhupada actually at the right age of 15, he took vanaprastha. He went to Vrindavan. Eventually he took sannyas and went to America as a single man. Single-handedly he started. You know, within a dozen years he expanded the spiritual devotee population. Practically 10,000 people were aspiring for initiation from him. 5,000 initiated. And started more than 100 temples. And he gave spiritual engagements to them. And made the GBCs. So that even after he leaves this world and goes back to Godhead, he can perpetuate the spiritual activities. So, you can see Prabhupada was a grand success in the spiritual plane. Even materialists are envying him. Seeing this, Swamiji went with 40 rupees and came back with 40 crores. Building 3 temples in 3 places in India. Mayapur and Vrindavan and Mumbai. And that too in old age. Old age Indians take the grandson for a walk or a dog for a walk, reading newspaper, watching TV, relaxing at home in an easy chair. Retired means you are supposed to relax. But in the age when people begin retiring from work, Prabhupada began his actual work. So, therefore, one should know that material life is certain to be doomed. It's only a matter of today or tomorrow. So one should take to spiritual life and the human form of life seriously. So Raghunath Das had that seriousness even at an early stage. So although his father would try to bind him back. This is always a competition that happens in Odisha also. Many parents feel that, oh son, you don't become like Lord Chaitanya. They will say, you don't renounce everything and, you know, run away to Krishna. But if neighbor's son goes to Krishna, that's wonderful. But my son, he should not go for renouncing everything. So Bengal and Odisha people sometimes fear. But now ISKCON has created such amazing culture and amazing, you know, image in the world global map, due to which even nowadays many Bengali mothers are very proud that my son is dedicated to Krishna service in, you know, ISKCON in Mayapur. Even and for people of Bengal, Odisha, their heart is like gold, very naturally inclined to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And they have very great fondness for Mahaprabhu. So there was actually a feeling in those days that if my son goes to city and makes a lot of money, it'll be nice. But now even they are appreciating that ISKCON is doing very good work and my son is dedicating his life and he will spread the, you know, glories of mission. So they are happy. Of course there's a divided opinion. Some are happy, some are fond of more material life. Because some people cannot see beyond money. Money and land and followers, they can't see beyond that. So Raghunath Das, although belonged to a rich family, he ran away from home. But his father was trying to bring him back. Panchapai katare rakhe ratri dine. Chari sevaka dui brahmana rahe tarasane.
His father even had five watchmen guard him day and night. Four personal servants were employed to look after his comfort. And two brahmanas were employed to cook for him.
Five watchmen for what purpose? So that he will not run away. Watch him. And four personal servants for what?
Look after his comfort.
Like arranging accommodation, arranging his bedding, if he wants hot water, you know, getting some clothes, getting some, arranging some toiletries, whatever he wanted. If he wanted someone to go somewhere and purchase something and bring. So there were four personal servants and two brahmanas were
cooking.
For cooking for him. One cook and one assistant. So just for one boy, he has arranged so much facility. Because lavish family, no? Big family. Ekadasha janatare rake nirantara.
Ekadasha janatare rake nirantara.
Nirachale yaite napaya dukkita antara.
Nirachale yaite napaya dukkita antara.
In this way, 11 people were incessantly keeping Raghunatha Das under control. Thus, he could not go to Jagannatha Puri, and because of this, he was very unhappy.
Yevayadi Mahaprabhu Shantipura Aila.
Yevayadi Mahaprabhu Shantipura Aila.
Shuniya Pitare Raghunatha Nivedila.
Shuniya Pitare Raghunatha Nivedila.
Now he got the news, that Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is coming to Shantipur, so he requested his father now. He has to take permission now, otherwise all these fellows will not leave him. The father tells these fellows, let him go and come, then they will all leave him. Correct, no? Agya deha yaya deki prabhura charana.
Agya deha yaya deki prabhura charana.
Anyatana rahe mora sharire jivana.
Anyatana rahe mora sharire jivana.
Oh father, please allow me so that I may go and see Lord Chaitanya, otherwise I can't maintain my life. Either he, let me go and see his lotus feet and come. He begged his father. Shunitara pita bahu loka dravya diya.
Shunitara pita bahu loka dravya diya.
Pathaila bali shigra asiha firiya.
Pathaila prabhu tara shigra asiha
firiya. Hearing?
Hearing this request, Raghunatha Das's father agreed. Giving him many servants and materials, the father sent him to see Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, requesting him to return soon.
Come back soon, he told him, yeah. सात दिन शांतिपुरे प्रभु संगे रहे.
सात दिन शांतिपुरे प्रभु संगे रहे.
रात्रि दिवस मन कथा कहे.
रात्रि दिवस मन कथा
कहे. So 7 days he stayed with the association of Mahaprabhu. In those days, days and nights he had the following thoughts in his mind. What were the thoughts? Rakshake rahate mohi ke mane chutiba.
Rakshake rahate mohi ke mane chutiba.
Ke mane prabhu rasange nila chale yava.
Ke mane prabhu rasange nila chale yava.
Oh, how can I get rid of these people who are trying to protect me on behalf of my father? So that I can go to Neelachal, Jagannath Puri and stay in the association of Mahaprabhu for all time. That kind of desire he had. He wanted to get rid of the clutches of the watchman and everybody. Sarvajna Gauranga Prabhu Jani Taramana.
Sarvajna Gauranga Prabhu Jani Taramana.
Shiksha Rupe Kahe Tare. Ashwasavachana.
Shiksha Rupe Kahe Tare. Ashwasavachana.
So, Sarvajna means all knowing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. See, simply by looking at Raghunatha Mahaprabhu understood what this fellow is up to. He is born in a very millionaire family, but he has no taste for money, no taste for material enjoyment. He simply wanted to dedicate everything and come to meet, be with me. So now he is going to give Shiksha Rupe. He is giving and he gave him words, reassuring words and gave him some instructions, which is very important, which Lord Chaitanya spoke to Raghunatha Das. What he spoke to him, see here he says. स्थिरहया अगरे याओ नाहाओ वातुला
स्थिरहया अगरे याओ नाहाओ वातुला
क्रमे क्रमे पायलोक भव सिंधु कुला
क्रमे क्रमे पायलोक भव सिंधु कुला
बी पेशेंट एंड रिटर्न होम डोंट बी क्रेजी फेलो बाय एंड बाय यू विल बी एबल टू क्रॉस द मशीन
बाय एंड बाय बाय एंड बाय
बाय एंड बाय यू विल बी एबल टू क्रॉस द portion of material existence.
Yeah, see, he says, Stirahaya, be patient. Gare yavo, go back home. Naho vatula, don't be crazy. Krame krame paya. By and by, gradually, Baba Sindhu Kula, you'll be able to cross over the ocean of material existence. Don't be in a hurry, do patiently, he says. And then Prabhupada is quoting that famous verse, Samashitaya Padavallava Pravam. Material world is like a big ocean, begins with Brahma Loka to Patara Loka. Without knowing the ocean, there is a living, it is wandering everywhere. Everyone is trying to get out of the ocean of material existence. You cannot immediately reach the coast, but you have to keep on endeavoring. By Mahaprabhu's mercy, gradually you will. One may be very eager to cross the ocean, but he can't attain success by acting like a madman. He must swim over the ocean very patiently and intelligently under the instructions of Jagat Mahaprabhu and his guru, representative. Then one day he will reach the shore. It's like a marathon running. Marathon is 40 kilometers. So you cannot just speedily, if you run after 1 kilometer, you will sit down. Correct, no? So one should know how to steadily. Therefore, you will find people who are running in marathon, very steady running they will do. They have a lot of stamina. And spiritual, we also need spiritual stamina in spiritual life. So for that stamina, we need three things. Utsahan, Usyaha, Dhairyat. Yeah. So we should be enthusiastic. But that enthusiasm should be tempered with other two. Yeah, the patience, yeah. And the nishchayat, dhairyat. Actually, nishchayat means confidence and faith and determination. Yeah, and dhairyat means patience. Yeah. See, if you have only patience, then you go to tamaguna. Correct? No? If you have only utsaha, then you go to passion, rajaguna, isn't it? And if you have nishchayat, confidence and faith and determination, then you have goodness. Actually, determination is there in all the three. Rajaguna, tamaguna, sattvaguna. But we need the goodness type of intelligence where we can be steady. So Mahaprabhu said, steadily you should endeavor. Don't be in a hurry, Mahaprabhu said. Markada vairagya nakara, nakara loka dekaya.
Markada vairagya nakara loka dekana.
यथा योग्य विषय भुंज अनासक्त हैया
यथा योग्य विषय भुंज अनासक्त हैया
यू शुड नॉट मेक योरसेल्फ अ शो बॉटल डिवोटी एंड बिकम अ फॉल्स रेनुंशियर फॉर द टाइम बीइंग एंजॉय द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड इन अ बी फिटिंग वे एंड डू नॉट बिकम अटैच्ड टू
इट सो दिस इज अ वेरी डीप इंस्ट्रक्शन दैट महाप्रभु इज गिविंग हियर इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्स 16.238 This was a very important verse, because sometimes when we come to Krishna consciousness, what happens to grihastha families, if husband and wife are young couple, they are just married, they come to Krishna consciousness, then immediately they both think, oh, we are in Maya. We are trying to enjoy the world. We are putting up a house. We are trying to get a child. You know, we are going to market and purchasing so many things. We are supposed to live a very simple life. So, if they become very renounced, they go to one extreme. They think, oh, I should not appreciate my wife. I should not be attracted to her beauty. I should just, you know, be only Krishna conscious. And she thinks, you know, I am only property of Krishna, not this fellow. This man is another living entity. He has come home here. He cannot touch me. He cannot enjoy me. I can't go near him. So I will be renounced, like that wife thinks. So then what happens? Wife is in one room, husband is in another room. They don't even see each other. And due to renunciation, eventually, because their desire to enjoy is there. But because of that, eventually they become angry at each other. That leads to separation. They want to divorce. The matter goes up to parents, and there will be a lot of confusion due to this artificial renunciation. This is one extreme. And another extreme, which has been seen, is that people, as soon as they marry, they become sense gratification oriented. They are wearing glamorous dresses and giving poses in different directions, clicking. Nowadays people click photos and put in WhatsApp and send it to all their friends, and goes all around the world. They look like, they try to dress up like heroes and heroines and giving different type of poses, very intimate poses and all. They click photos and send to everybody. Crazy it is. As if, you know, they want to show to the world who we are and how we are enjoying life, see us, and, you know, and then they become sense gratified. They completely forget devotion service altogether and give it up. You know, and you ask them, where is the bead bag? Then they say, we don't know bead bag. Now we are newly married now. They throw bead bag to one corner, tilak box to another corner, and the puja room is not getting an attention. Both are going here, rotating round and round them here and there, and they are putting up parties, calling their friends. They become sense enjoyed practically. That is another extreme. It's like that's in this way, it's like a pendulum. Either extremity of bhukti or tyaga, bhog or tyaga. Both are actually condemned. So then how should one live? How should a devotee live? That's what Mahaprabhu is saying. Enjoy the material world in a befitting way, but don't become attached to it. For example, one should show affection to the wife and children and mother and father. But if one becomes attached to them, then the home becomes the center. And then he is revolving around the, you know, wife and children like, you know, planet revolving around the sun, orbiting and going round and round. And he completely forgets his spiritual duty. That's the meaning of attachment. Just like Bharat Maharaj was, his consciousness was always rotating around the deer, very dear. So like that. So that is a very bad thing. Similarly, Dhritarashtra's consciousness was revolving around Duryodhana. All that I am making, I will make my son the king, he will be my successor. You know, I will not let royal seat to go to anybody else. So he simply became mad, attached. Like that. Same with Kaikeyi, he became attached to making Bharata the king. This kind of mental attachment. Similarly, so you find that Chitraketu became attached to Harshashoka, causing envy in the hearts of the other queens. You see, in this world you find that when people decide to enjoy the material world, so then that the enjoyment makes them become attached. But what Mahaprabhu is saying, you enjoy the material world without becoming attached. For example, Ambarish Maharaj, how is he enjoying? He is wearing the royal dress because he is a king. He can't wear dhoti kurta and simply live like a Sadhu Baba. He has to wear the royal dress, he has to wear the jewellery. He has to go to the court, he will go in a golden chariot. He will sit in an elevated seat. Everybody will get up and offer him respect. He will accept the respect. But his heart is not in all these things. He will accept these things as a format, as a kind of, you know, etiquette to be followed. Then he may take his wife and children to the temple. He may go offer obeisances to the Lord, render services. So you will see that the kingly duties he is performing. Bharat Maharaj, he also executed big yajnas for the sake of Praja. All the Brahmanas were called and the Brahmanas were performing Indraya, Swaha, Chandraya, all that they were doing. But he was not actually worshipping demigods. In his heart of hearts, he was worshipping Krishna only. But you will see that he executed all his duties very dutifully, responsibly, properly. Although externally it appeared that he is doing activities like a karmi. His heart was not in those things. He was aloof. His heart was sold out to Krishna. you would hear the Srimad Bhagavatam, chant the holy name, and you would spend the night. So in this way, Mahaprabhu told him that enjoy the material world. How in ISKCON society, how the family, couples, husband, wife, they enjoy the spiritual life. I mean, enjoy in the material world. They have a house close to the temple. They wear very nice dresses. They come to the temple. They take part in the festivals. Mataji's cook bhoga for the Lord. You know, make garlands for the Lord. Prabhuji comes and takes part in book distribution. Various activities like that. And also they have classes together in their homes. Also they celebrate festivals, decorating the home. Actually, husband wife should be in sattvaguna. Sattvaguna means they wish to serve each other, assist each other, cooperate with each other, put aside the false ego, not see one another as object of exploitation and enjoyment, but see one another as Krishna's devotee, as spiritual partners. In the course of being husband, wife, spiritual partners, and if they live life like this, there will certainly be affection between them. And at the appropriate time, with the permission and blessing of Guru, they will unite and beget children. And the children also, they will raise them in Krishna consciousness. For them, sex life is not a very important aspect of life, that is everything. That is only for non-devotee karmis. For them, there is nothing in this world to... It's like puna puna charvita, charvanana. For non-devotees, it's like they are... Again and again, you put the sugar cane in the machine. Already juice is out, nothing is coming. Still you keep putting, keep biting like that. So, for those who are devotees, their enjoyment actually comes in performing pious and spiritual activities for Krishna along with wife, children, family, everybody. So, and one has to actually give attention, time to mother, father, wife, children and family. And also one should give them suitable engagement. Prabhupada says in Bhagavatam Purport, a man should give 2-3 children to the wife so she is very busy taking care of the children. And then he can engage in devotion service very nicely. He says, because women are generally fond of their husband who is giving them a good house, good clothes to wear, good ornaments to wear, and good babies to grow, and he is gentle spoken, gentlemanly in speech, he is kind and courteous in his speech. And then after having given all these things, the husband is dancing in the kirtan, they have no problem. They will say, he has given me what I want. So they are peaceful. So, but the husband who is simply like a Srilampat, who becomes very attached to his wife's body, and he considers his wife's body as meant for sexual enjoyment, and that becomes a prominent goal for a husband. Even women get fed up with such a person. This fellow is crazy after me. Huh? You know, he is not doing his chanting, he is not going to temple, he is not engaging in service, nor is he able to make good money also. You know, he's neither success in material life nor success in spiritual life. He is only behind me. And women get fed up also. Such a woman cannot respect the husband. So therefore, one should not go to the extremes of bhoga or tyag. One should know the balance between the two. So Shastras say, be affectionate, but don't become attached. You know, be detached, but don't become indifferent. It says, what is the meaning of that? Be detached, don't become indifferent means, okay, heart of heart, you may be detached from all these things, but don't show it externally that, no, I am detached. You know, I will not wear this costly dress. I am a king, but I will wear only a cowpin. You know, you can't say that. You know, a king, I may have to wear a ring, you know, golden bangles and very nice costly dresses. But you may, so be detached in the heart, but don't be indifferent to them. When the royal respect is given, don't discard it, because then common people cannot understand what you are doing. So like that, this also says, so Mahaprabhu, let us see, Purport, Prabhupada explains, read it.
The word Markata Vairagya, indicating false renunciation, is very important in this world. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, in commenting on this word, points out that monkeys make an external show of renunciation by not accepting clothing and by living naked in the forest. In this way, they consider themselves renunciates, but actually they are very busy enjoying some gratification with dozens of female monkeys. Such renunciation is called Markata Vairagya.
Markata means monkey.
The renunciation of a monkey. One cannot be really renounced until one actually becomes disgusted with material activity and sees it as a stumbling block to spiritual advancement. renunciation should not be phalgu, temporary, but should exist throughout one's life. Temporary renunciation or monkey renunciation is like the renunciation one feels at a cremation ground. When a man takes a dead body to the crematorium, he sometimes thinks, this is the final end of the body. Why am I working so hard day and night? Such sentiments naturally arise in the mind of any man who goes to a crematory ghata. However, as soon he returns from the cremation ground, he again engages in material activity for sense enjoyment. This is called smashana vairagya, market vairagya.
You will see, when a man dies next day morning, somebody will say, really, he died? Yesterday night, 9 o'clock, I was speaking to him. We were sitting together casually, half an hour, 1 hour, joking and talking. And he passed away. Just see what this world is. Now he is dead. Such a rich man, leaving behind crores of rupees. Kya rakha hai duniya mein? And people speak like that. And when they are going to the smashan, everybody is silent. You know, very somber, very morose. And the body is being burnt, everybody is seeing the body. Oh, such a great man, the body is burnt to ashes, only skeleton remains. What this world is, everything has mixed with the sand. And now that we can't see him anymore, his activities are finished. So they think like that. And then, but when they are returning from the smashan, immediately on the way only they talk. He has two sons and two daughters. Any will he has written or what? What he is going to give business to whom? He is going to give land to whom? Village property he will give to whom? And all the talk starts then. Even on the way back only, yeah. So again, the things of the world cling on to them. So what vairagya is this? Smashan vairagya. Read further.
In order to render service to the Lord, one may accept necessary things. If one lives in this way, he may actually become renounced. In the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, 1.2.7.
See, if one lives in this way means what? You should only accept things necessary for you, not what you are greedy for. So there is a need versus greed. Correct, no? Right. Yeah. But there is a necessity versus luxury. So which one we should look for? Luxury or greed? Which one?
Necessity.
actually, need versus greed. Necessity versus luxury. In this way, need and necessity are proper. But greed and luxury are not proper. Referee is saying that one may accept only necessary things. So, but unfortunately what happens in this world is, people look at others. They think, my friend is using a car, why should I use a bike? My friend is using a Mercedes Benz and I am using a Santro car, what will world think of me? Well, nobody will think of you. Everybody is busy in their own things. It's only our own mind which says, ego which says, what will the world think of me? Log kya bolenge? What will, this kind of imagination, foolish imagination. So people compare and think, like, you know, imagine if a cat wants to become like a tiger, is it possible? Like one is a middle class man and his friend is a millionaire or billionaire. He wants to become like him. You know, how foolish it would be. If the cat wants to be like a tiger, it thinks, it looks at the face in the mirror, oh, face is at least matching, close to a tiger. Only thing is, I need little more josh, little more strength and power to, you know, capture a deer or something like that. So what he does, he goes to the kitchen and takes a firewood and puts a strip in his body. And looks in the mirror, how I look? And he looks like that. So simply putting fire stick strips, do you think he becomes a tiger? Even on face he can put, look in the mirror. Isn't it? So therefore in this world people become greedy. Therefore they become greedy. Looking at others. Unhealthy comparisons. So Mahaprabhu here Prabhupada says, in order to render service to the Lord, one may accept necessary things. Okay, how much you need for doing service? For example, somebody may say, oh, we want to have an altar, so we should go for a bigger house. Let us go for independent bungalow. Husband may say, oh, see, you don't need an independent bungalow just because you want to have an altar. Even in a 2 BHK, you can have an altar if you want. No, no, we want to give a bigger place for the Lord. Some people say like that. Actually, if the Lord wants big place, you want. Isn't it? So, you will see, this is the way people, like somebody may say, no, we want to go to temple, so let us buy a car. Okay. Now you're going in a scooter, Maruti car, 3-4 lakh you spent to buy. But sometimes, let's have a comfortable car, you know, buy 25 lakh rupees car. So you will find that sometimes in the name of devotional service, we may expand our material life also. We may not be knowing also. That's due to greed. Therefore, we have to know what is my social status, what is my financial status, you know, can I afford this? How do you know can I afford this? It should be, you should be able to get it without taking a loan. You should be able to get it without much difficulty. And you should not feel a strain, financial strain in getting that. It should be very smooth and easy within, this is your pocket, this is your earning. Is it fitting within this? Or I have to put my hand in one more pocket, loan. So easily we can know. We don't need very costly things. We should not become greedy. So he's saying that to render devotional service to the Lord, one, you accept necessary things. If you live in that way, he may actually become renounced, he says. Such a grihastha gradually becomes renounced. But a grihastha becomes greedy, luxurious, very bad. Then he becomes very materially oriented, materialistic, more and more materialistic. Actually, there are grihasthas who initially were very simple, but then somehow or other they got a bigger job, opportunities to go abroad, they made more money and came back. Then they wanted a bigger house, bigger car, bigger facilities. Gradually, you don't see them anymore. They're not coming for Sunday program. You don't see them visiting temple. You don't see them taking part in festivals. And you call them, they say, Prabhu, you have taken a bigger house, little far away from temple. It becomes difficult to come and go. Okay, it becomes difficult at least twice a month you can come, but you don't turn up only. People become very busy in material lives. So, and then they become their, you don't see their face only. There are people like that. People go away. So therefore, the reason for that is, sometimes if you are materially well off, then one thing is what the need of devotion service. Anyway, I have enough money, my children are grown up, and they are also very healthy and they are doing well in their studies. Their daughter is going to Boston and the son is going to Houston. They are very proud. My another daughter is in Australia and one is in Canada. In this way, I am a great soul. All my 4 children are in 4 different parts of the world. And they are floating in money and they are sending me money also. And I have a big bungalow, I have a car. Why do I need God? One thing. One doesn't realize, why do you need God? Next moment, one can get a heart attack and you become a dog in the next neighboring street. It can happen to a person. Now, one becomes a dog, one will realize, my Lord, I was living in such a house with so much facilities and children, and he was such a big man. This doesn't enter the head, especially when one is intoxicated. One should always be aware, smaranityam anityatam. This material world is temporary. Tyaja durjana samsargam, bhaja sadhu samagamam, kuru punya maho ratram, smaranityam anityatam. Very beautiful instruction Chanakya gives here. He is saying that, tyaja durjana samsargam, give up bad association, says. Bhaja sadhu samagamam, come in this association of saintly people. Kuru punya maho ratram, day and night accumulate bhakti sukrutis. Smaranityam anityatam, always remember the material world is temporary. So therefore we should not go from need to greed. If you are happy with need, gradually that will lead you to renounced life easily. Same thing with brahmacharis also. If you only take your need and keep your material necessities very small, then very soon such brahmacharis are want to become popular, you want to be a hero. If you want to be a hero, you want a heroine, then naturally, that is how you will find many brahmacharis gradually when they became very lavish in their lifestyle and eating. Therefore, Mahaprabhu says, Balana kaipe, balana padipe, hridayate sarvada Radha Krishna sevibe. He says, don't eat opulently, don't dress opulently, always in your heart think of Radha and Krishna. And then, gramyavarta na kaipe, do not gossip with people, like ordinary people. Gramyavarta na kaipe, gramyavarta na shunibe, kane, he says, don't hear mundane prajalpa from different people. So always keep doing Krishna Katha, hearing Krishna Katha, speaking Krishna Katha. He says that the brahmachari should lead a very simple life. And simple life will make him more and more renounced, and he can be happily renounced. That's the most important thing. Not the renunciation, you see it as a punishment or something. No. Actually, you gradually realize these imaginary demands who are chasing me before, I actually don't need them. Mm-hmm. This is all just imagination. Mm-hmm. Like for example, you know, you have many brahmacharis using a simple button phone. And I also have been using a button phone for years together, and I don't feel anything big missing just because I don't have a WhatsApp or I don't have a smartphone or something like that. Button phone mein kaam ho jata, everything is over. And in case something very pressing, you can always use an email or something. But somebody was used WhatsApp for many years. Now you make a new policy in temple, tell them, no more WhatsApp now. You use only a mobile. My God, you will feel, you cut my hands. You as if they feel hands are cut off, you are his handicapped, you may feel like that. Because once you go from need to greed, to go from greed to need is not very easy after that. So therefore now in our Pune temple, for those who desperately need WhatsApp use, we are giving them in computer. Okay, you have a computer, at least you will not frequently use it. If you are using computer to open the computer and start and see, you will not be all the time having it in your fingertips. So the point is, keep life simple. Yavata syat svanirvaha.
Yavata syat svanirvaha.
Svikuryat tavadartavit.
Svikuryat tavadartavit.
Adikye nyunatayamcha.
Adikye nyunatayamcha.
Shavate paramartataha.
Shavate paramartataha.
Translation.
The bare necessities of life must be accepted, but one should not superfluously increase these necessities, nor should they be unnecessarily decreased. One should simply accept what is necessary to help one advance spiritually.
For spiritual advancement sake, you can accept things. And we are not like Phalgu Vairagi also. Okay. Phalgu Vairagi is who? For example, there are one class of renunciates who say they only walk barefoot. They will never use a chappal. And they will never go by vehicle also. No car, no bus, no train. Wherever they go walking, place to place. They are Phalgu Vairagi. Why? Because if you have to preach, you know, you may have to travel far away. As Krishna devotees, we don't mind even taking a flight, even taking a train, you know, whatever is facilities available for reaching out Krishna consciousness, we use. But we don't accept facilities for enjoyment. We accept facilities for Krishna service. Nirbandha Krishna Sambandhe Yuktam Vairagyam Uchyate. We have to make sure that we are accepting facility only for Krishna service. That's very important.
In his Durgama Sangamani, Sri Jiva Goswami
comments
that the word Swanirvaha actually means Swa
Swa Bhakti Nirvaha. Swa Nirvaha is not personal maintenance. Somebody may say, Prabhuji, for personal maintenance I need a Innova car. No, it's not your own bodily maintenance. It is Swa Swa Bhakti Nirvaha. He is making very clear point. Actually, it is for, you should accept facilities for performing devotional service, not for pampering your body. Like that, he is making very clearly. The experienced devotee will accept only those material things that will help him render service to the Lord. For example, they are asking me, Prabhu, is this room good enough for you to stay? We all are shifting to a new temple, new building, I mean, a new ashrama. Then I may ask, okay, this is one room. What more you have? Prabhu, there is another room which is double this size. There is one more room which is four times this size. Which one you prefer? They ask you. Then one may say, oh really? Maybe let me see that also. Let me see this also. So then four times, like football ground, you take four times the size of a big room, you take it. He may say that, oh, this is better because this is the best room you are offering me, so let me take it. Is it good to take it? What is the first thing we should think? How much will I utilize it? Correct, no? Like I have an office in New Vedi Cultural Center. But in that office, there is no table, no chair. I kept the office empty. Can you guess why? Because, you know, when I am traveling, almost 80% of the time I am traveling outdoor, 70-80%. So, at that time, I told all the seminar givers and devotees who are preaching, can use my office. It has a number lock. And the manager knows it. Anybody wants to use it, can come and use it. Why? Because it is not my property that nobody can enter inside. It is whose property? Krishna's property. When I am away, why can't others use the place? But if you take a very big place, You know, four times this room, and then you put your table, your sofa, your chair, you occupy the whole place, and you keep your lock and key, and you're traveling 80% of the time. So that place goes underutilized, unutilized, unused. But it whose property? So swa bhakti nirvaha means for my performance of bhakti, how much facility do I need? Exactly that much only I should take. And if I am not using, what I should do? Give it to other Vaishnavas, let them use it. Like, you know, people sometimes come and give me pens. Prabhuji, here is a gift for you, thank you. So I collect pen, one pen, two pen. I find suddenly one day I open the cupboard and there are 2 dozen pens. So am I using it? Then what I should do? Give it away to other Vaishnavas. So whatever is not coming to my performance of Bhakti Yoga, but I am accumulating, I should not accumulate. One should give it away. So in this way, swa swa bhakti nirvaha, like that Jiva Goswami says. Always, so one exercise all of you can do. Now when you go back, what you do? Make a list of all things that you have. How many books I have accumulated which I never touch? I don't read. Then you may approach, I have to give away all the books. Now you keep the books, but make sure you
read.
And if somebody want to read, you can also have a register where you give books and take back from the devotees that they wish to read. So that means you can lend. Swasva bhakti nirvaha. Take only what you are using well. Similarly, how many clothes you have? Do you need 2 dozen clothes? You have to ask the question. How many vehicles you have? How much place are you occupying? You know, how much? Sometimes while giving prasad also, people say that, Prabhuji, put more, little more. Why? Because it may get over. Afterwards, it may get? It's a very tasty item. Better you put. No problem, put it. But after finishing half plate, they can't eat it. Why? Because they have taken? Is it swasva bhakti nirvaha?
No.
See, don't accept more than. So, one more thing they can do. If you want to take in another vessel and keep it in the side, after finishing, if you are not able to finish, what you can do? Give it away to other devotees. See, the simple things I am telling you. Very simple things. Swasva bhakti nirvaha. Beautiful verse, no? So, now you can go back and do this exercise. Put 2 circles. One circle here, one. Swasva bhakti nirvaha, keep in one circle. And other things which are not coming in the category, what you do? Keep in this circle. And what you do with the circle? Start disposing. Then, you will see that swasva bhakti nirvaha circle, that will produce renunciation. That's you will not only renounce things, you will be blissful, blissfully you will renounce and you can be very happy. Yes. The experienced devotee will accept only those material things that will help him in rendering service to the Lord. Bhaktisam Sindhu says, Markata Vairagya Phalgu Vairagya is explained as follows. Prapanchikataya buddhya hari sambandhi vastanaha mumukshavi parityago vairagyam phalgu katyate.
When persons eager to achieve liberation renounce things related to the Supreme Personality of God, thinking them to be material, the renunciation is called inconclusive.
If something can be utilized in Krishna service, the devotee does not reject it. For example, some millionaire comes and says, Swamiji, you know, I have some money, so do you think is there any use for it? I will say, yes, please get me some 4 sumos. Because 1 sumo is 8 lakh or something, 8 or 10 lakh. Get me 4 sumos, I want to send devotees to 4 villages for distributing books. So like that you can accept facility somebody is providing, not that somebody is giving money, you have to say no. Yeah, go ahead.
Whatever is favorable for the rendering of service to the Lord should be accepted and should not be rejected as a material thing.
Yes.
Yukta Vairagya or befitting renunciation is thus explained.
Anasaktasya Vishayan Yadarham Upayunjataha Nirbanda Krishna Sambande Yuktam Vairagya Muchyate.
Things should be accepted for the Lord's service and not for one's personal sense gratification.
That is the point. Yeah.
If one accepts something without attachment and accepts it because it is related to Krishna, one's renunciation is called Yukta Vairagya. Since Krishna is the absolute truth, whatever is accepted for his service is also the absolute truth. The word Markata Vairagya is used by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to indicate so-called Vaishnavas who dress themselves in loincloths, trying to imitate Srila Rupa Goswami. Such people carry a bead bag and chain, but at heart they are always thinking about getting woman and money. Unknown to others, these Markata Vairagis maintain woman but externally present themselves as renunciates. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very much opposed to these Markata Vairagis or pseudo Vaishnavas.
So the Shuddha Vaishnavas are more eager to appear saintly than being saintly. Appearing saintly means externally they may wear a very simple dress, or they may wear only a kaupi in loin cloth and take a bead bag and chant in a place where all people will come and bow down to them and go. They say, "Oh, Babaji, Sadanam there." And they would say, "He is always with Krishna." You know, this is called cheap popularity. Imitating who? Haridas Thakur. Yeah, they imitate Haridas Thakur chanting many rounds. But they maintain relationship with widows secretly, without anyone's knowledge. You know. They know their names, they know their whereabouts. They secretly connect with them and they have illicit connections with them. And these people become monkeys and dogs in Dham, Prabhupada says, in the next life. Because of such intimacy, and they are very strongly condemned by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Gaurara ame, mukhe bolile nahi chale. Gaurara achara, gaurara vichara, doila pala pale.
What he says, Gaurara ame, I am follower of Chaitanya, like that many people claim wearing tilak and kantimala and everything. But he's saying, bolile nahi chale, that's not enough. He's saying, Gaurara achara, gaurara vichara. Achara means Lord Chaitanya's behavior was very strict with opposite sex. And Gaurara vichara means Lord Chaitanya's philosophy is Jiva Rasarupo Hai, Krishna Nityadas. So one has to have the same philosophy of Chaitanya and the lifestyle of Lord Chaitanya. Loila palapale, then you will get the fruit. That means your presentation of the truth should be perfect and your representation of Mahaprabhu should be perfect. Presentation and representation. That means, you know, philosophy should be pakka, Vaishnava philosophy, and lifestyle should be a proper sadachar, both are required. Tattva and sadachar, both are required. And then he is saying,
Loka dekana gaurabaja tilak matra dhari gopanite atyachara gaur dhare churi.
He is saying that secretly, openeth, he is saying that loka dekana, just to show to the people, Gaurabaje, and they sing very sweetly also. They may sing very beautifully, mardangam, harmonium and everything they play. Loka dekana, gaurabaja, tilak matra dhari, they may wear a tilak. And they look like what? Proper Vaishnava, they look like that. But gopanete means secretly. Atyachara, they do atrocious activities, like stalking money, connecting with women, secretly trying to become popular by making a show bottle show, like Haridas Thakur type of imitation. The Haridas Thakur is genuine acharya, but they like to imitate him to become popular like him. Therefore, our Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur condemned, no? He said, Dushtamana tumi kisera Vaishnava. Like their own song he sang. And he talks about, don't imitate great souls. Follow in their footsteps. So, Gopanaiti Atyachara Gaur Dare Churi, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will not accept you if you are a show bottle Vaishnava. Be a genuine Vaishnava, he is saying. So, Mahaprabhu taught the same thing to Raghunath Das.
Antaranishtakara Bakiloka Vyavahara Ajirat Krishna Tomaya Karibe Udhara
Ajirat Krishna Tomaya Karibe Udhara.
See, Antaranishtakara Bakiloka means manage your business externally, meditate on Krishna internally. That's the formula. Antaranishtakara means meditate on Krishna internally. Bakiloka Vyavahara, manage your business externally. I mean, be like a Pounds and Shillong, materially enthusiastic businessman. Where?
Outside.
You look like that externally. But in the heart of hearts, what you do? Antarini Sakara. Meditate on Krishna internally always. Then what will happen to you? Achira Krishna Tamaya Karibe Uddhar. Very, Chirat means long time. Achirat means? In very short time, Krishna will very soon deliver you. Like that Mahaprabhu is telling. Yeah.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu continued, within your heart, you should keep yourself very faithful, but externally you may behave like an ordinary man. Thus, Krishna will soon be very pleased and deliver you from the clutches of Maya.
Yeah. वृंदावन देखी अबे आसी बनीला चले,
वृंदावन देखी अबे आसी बनीला चले,
तबे तुम्हें आमा पास आसी का कौन चले,
तबे तुम्हें आमा पास आसी का कौन चले।
You may see me at Neelachala, Jagannathpuri when I return after visiting Vrindavan. By that time, you can think of some trick to escape.
He's given a clue also. Mahaprabhu. Now Mahaprabhu says that I'm going to Vrindavan now, and then I come back by the time. Now at the moment you go back and enter service, at appropriate time you can come. से चले से काले कृष्ण सुरावे तुम्हारे,
चले से काले कृष्ण सुरावे तुम्हारे,
कृष्ण कृपा यारे तारे केरा किते पारे,
कृष्ण कृपा यारे तारे केरा किते पारे।
से चले से काले कृष्ण सुरावे तुम्हारे,
चले से काले कृष्ण सुरावे तुम्हारे,
कृष्ण कृपा यारे तारे के राखीते पारे,
कृष्ण कृपा यारे तारे के राखीते पारे।
What kind of means you will have to use at that time will be revealed by Krishna. If one has Krishna's mercy, no one can check.
Such amazing statement, you see. Because the Lord in our heart is always inspiring. You know, He will give us ideas. If you are serious about going back to Godhead, He will tell you what to do, when. He will tell you. That's what is a very important verse. Se chala, that trick. Se kale, at that time, Krishna surave tumhare. Krishna will inspire you from your heart. Se chala, se kale, Krishna surave tumhare. And Krishna kripa yare. The person who has achieved Krishna's mercy, tare ke rakite pare, is asking, you know, who can keep him, who is able to hold him? Nobody can check him. Like that he is saying. Such a beautiful verse, no? Yeah, really?
Although Srila Raghunatha Dasa was very anxious to join Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Lord advised him to wait for the mercy of Krishna. He recommended that Raghunatha Dasa keep his Krishna consciousness firmly fixed in his heart, while externally behaving like an ordinary man. This is a trick for everyone advanced in Krishna consciousness. One can live in a society like an ordinary human being, but at the same time, one's own business should be to satisfy Krishna and spread His glories. A Krishna conscious person should not be absorbed in material things, for his only business is the devotional service of the Lord. If one is engaged in this way, Krishna will certainly bestow His mercy. As Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advised Raghunatha Dasa, yatha yogya vishaya bhunja
anasakta haiya.
The same is repeated, antara nishtakara bhaiya loka vyavahara. This means that one must have no desire within his heart other than to serve Krishna. On the basis of such a conviction, one can cultivate Krishna consciousness. This is confirmed in the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1.2.200.
Laukike vaidike vapiya क्रिया क्रिय लौकिकी वैदिकी वापी या क्रिया क्रियते मुने हरि सेवानुकूलैव सा कार्या भक्तिम इच्छता। यस, यू कैन रीड द ट्रांसलेशन।
अ डिवोटी मे एक्ट एज एन ऑर्डिनरी ह्यूमन बीइंग और एज अ स्ट्रिक्ट फॉलोअर ऑफ वेरी इंडक्शन इन एवरी केस एवरीथिंग ही डज इज फेवरेबल फॉर द एडवांसमेंट ऑफ डिवोशनल सर्विस बिकॉज़ ही इज इन कृष्ण
कॉन्शियसनेस। लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल, यू नो, सम वैष्णव मे बी अ बिजनेसमैन, some Vaishnava be a musician like our George Harrison, but he is making a record which goes worldwide and brings popularity for ISKCON, you know, like that. Or the Vaishnava may be a householder with wife, children, business, everything. So he is making money, but he is giving a big monetary support to the society. Or one may be a strict brahmachari, or a pujari, brahmana, or maybe a sannyasi. So he can be in any role, he says. As long as you are performing Krishna consciousness in a faithful, genuine manner, external appearances are superficial. Krishna will not see that. He will only see the heart. Is this person genuinely trying to please me? He will see that. So, very beautifully this explains it. Okay. एतक हि महाप्रभु तारे विदाय दिला,
एतक हि महाप्रभु तारे विदाय दिला,
घरे आसी महाप्रभु रा शिक्षा आचरिला,
घरे आसी महाप्रभु रा शिक्षा आचरिला।
इन दिस वे श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु बेग फेयरवेल टू रघुनाथ दास who returned home and did exactly what the Lord told him.
Bhagya Vairagya Vatulata Sakala Chadiya
Bhagya Vairagya Vatulata Sakala Chadiya
Yata Yogya Karya Kare Anasakta Hiya
Yata Yogya Karya Kare Anasakta Hiya.
After returning home, Raghunatha Dasa gave up all craziness and external pseudo renunciation and engaged in his household duty without attachment.
So exactly he did that. That's what Mahaprabhu told him. That means don't run away from household duties. Do them, but without attachment. That means you give your heart to Krishna, not that now only you want to give your body to Krishna. There are many boys who say that, Prabhupada, in first year only I want to stop my studies and join full time. And what will happen, you know, that will create a big disturbance in the college, in the home, in the society. And he is apakva, he is like a kacha mango. Instead, what should one do? Finish studies, do a job, and get sisters married and settled and everything, and fulfill the duties to parents. After 10 years, 8 years or so, when one is like 25, 28, still one has to check whether I have a very strong desire to dedicate life. By the time, mind may change also, because one is associating with the outside world, mind may change. But one's fiery spirit of dedicating life is still staunch. Even after associating with material world, one's heart is not given away to the material world. That means a person is a candidate for renunciation. Then he can dedicate life. There's no one should not prematurely drop the material world in a kaccha stage. That will create trouble to one as well as the world also. Dekita ra pita mata bada sukha paila.
Dekita ra pita mata bada sukha paila.
Tahar avarna kichu shitla haila.
When Raghunatha Dasa's father and mother saw that their son was acting like a householder, they became very happy. Because of this, they slackened their bonds. When Raghunatha Dasa's father and mother saw that their son was no longer acting like a crazy fellow and was responsibly attending to his duties, they became very happy. The 11 people, 5 watchmen, 4 personal servants and 2 brahmanas who were guarding him became less strict in their vigilance. When Raghunatha Dasa actually took up his household affairs, his parents reduced the number of guards.
They felt there was no need now. Correct, na?
Right.
So, now one word was used there in the previous verses. Chala means the trick. And Lord Chaitanya said, Lord Krishna will reveal the trick to you. Different renunciates have adopted sometimes different tricks, especially in difficult situations. Like Sanatana Goswami, you know, he was working as a Sanatana, and Roop Sanatana were working as finance and home ministers for Nawab Hussain Shah. And Nawab Hussain Shah could hand over the whole service to them, and he didn't have to bother at all. But then they were thinking, when will you dedicate our life to Lord Chaitanya? So Rupa Goswami dropped his job and went away to Mahaprabhu. So naturally, Nawab Hussain Shah would be very angry. And then he told Sanatana, don't come with me, both of us should not go together. First I will go, you can slowly come. After some months, Sanatana Goswami one day said, I am sick. In the pretext of being sick, he went home. And almost a couple of weeks passed, he wasn't coming for job. Then the king little bit suspected, these two brothers are trying to slip out of my hands. So he went to his house, suddenly opening the door, he entered. Because he came to know from one confidential fellow that in his home he is not sick. What is happening? Bhagavatam study he is doing. So the king came, he said, hey Sanatan, I mean, his name was Sakara Mallik. Sakara Mallik, what are you doing? You are like my younger brother. You know, I am going out and invading the countries, here there is no one to take care of the government. Why are you not doing the job? You know, in the pretext of sickness, you are doing like this. And Sanatana said, O King, you are a representative of God. You can punish me if you like, or you can spare me. I have worked for you many years. Now I want time to dedicate my life, to my study of the scriptures. You can look for someone else in my place. And I want to be relieved from my job. The king was very angry. He insisted, you have only 2 choices. Either you will continue the job or I will put you in the jail. Teacher, I cannot work anymore and you are a representative of God. Whatever you feel, deem fit to do with me. Like that, Sanatan said. The king thought if I put him in jail for some time, he will agree to finally do the job. Because in job, I am giving him an independent palace, huge amount of gold coins. So, who will not take up the job? So, he will eventually come to track, he thought. Then he put him in the jail and king went away. But then Sanatan found out a trick. Chala. What is the chala he did? He told the jailkeeper, oh jailkeeper, I want to go to Mecca, Medina. See, every human being in life, at least once he should go to Mecca, Medina, isn't it? And you are a jinda peer, you are a great sage who has a big beard, you are a good soul, please kindly allow me. And that fellow, when he heard it, there were tears gliding down his eyes and beard also. He said, Sanatana, I understand, Sakara Malik. Same time, I am worried that the king may, you know, if I relieve you, he will cut my head, you know. And then Sanatana gave him some few thousand gold coins in the hand. He said, don't worry about the king. If king comes, you can tell him that I went to the riverside to pass toll. But then suddenly, along with the chains and hands and legs, I jumped into the river and I was washed away by the river. I have died. You can tell him like that. That fellow thought, that's a good idea also. Then another few thousand gold coins he gave him. When that man saw shining gold coins, he released the Sanatan from the jail. Sanatan came out and ran, fled to join Mahaprabhu through a very complex route. It was not through the regular road he went, because regular route any other guards may come and catch also. Instead of going to south, he went north and different directions he went. Therefore, he had to drink water and different places, not so good water, he got sick also. But what I am saying, you can see, every devotee will find out a trick to dedicate his life. And that trick will be revealed to him in the heart by Krishna, that Mahaprabhu said. So, this Raghunath Das section, talking with Mahaprabhu, we have concluded, nicely we discussed about it today, elaborately. So, there is only one section left, Lord Chaitanya returning to Jagannath Puri. And Lord Chaitanya recounting his travel, very nice. These two sections will get over in one class. Srila Prabhupada ki, Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki. Thank you very much.